If you wish to enjoy with a piece of art that is going to last over time, you can create your own, which I have here. It's the mask that I have created from the cement and pieces of broken CDs and DVDs, and you can see it's going to enhance greatly the place where you'll put it in your house. It's a very nice way to spend your time, and also it's a very nice way to create something that is going to bring you a lot of joy. As you can see from any angle, it's very nice to look at and gives this you the illusion that catches the light on every single piece of the CD or the DVD that I have used. So you can have this type of artwork in your home, and not only, of course, and you can just enjoy with a such nice look of the piece from any angle of your house. As you can see, the light reflects very well in every single piece, and again, it's very nice to look at, and look how much light brings to a place like I have here in my home. So I will show you how you can get this type of artwork, which is very easy to be created by any of you. So it's going to again bring you a lot of joy and a lot of pleasure working on this kind of piece. Hi, today I will show you another project that I wish to share it with you, and it's starting from this styrofoam head that I purchased it from dollar store. It's very inexpensive, or you can use a mask that you have left from Halloween or any other kind of mask. It doesn't matter, but the idea goes with any kind of mask that you use that you wish to use. So for this one, I have this head and I cut it in a half because works best for me in this way. And I'm trying to create a mask using this face. So because this head at one point will be covered in a mosaic, and this becomes very heavy, and I wish to have it a good look, I'm going to use like this piece of metal that I made a little bit of cavity here to fit the piece of metal here. And that is going to have a stand here and is going to be placed anywhere you wish, inside or outside of your place. So I'm going to show you how you can do this type of project. And for this, I'm using a piece of cloth that I have here. It's a cotton one. I'm using this kind because it absorbs the mixture of the cement very well. And here I have kind of runny composition of the cement and sand, two part sand, one part cement. And the water, it's like you have to add as much as you think that it's runny enough to absorb the composition in this cloth. So I'm just going to place the cloth here to absorb the mixture, and that is going to help me to create the face features for the mask. And if you need a little bit more water, you can add more. It's up to you, depending how big the project is that you are using the cloth as well. So I got here the cloth covered with the cement, and I'm looking for the hole that I had already. I cut it, it's a hole here, and that helps me to bring the piece of flat here and place it on top of the mask. I'm using those garden containers, plastic ones, because I need to have a place that it's like a tall, like to have enough space for the cloth to run on both sides evenly. So I'm just pushing the cloth everywhere on the mask here, and I'll just try to get the face features on the cloth. So that is the first part of the project, and that will help me to build further the face with the cement. Now, at this point, I'm sure that stays firmly in its place. It's distributed evenly on all sides, and I will start to just build the features for the face using the remaining cement here. And as you can see here, I have like a not so runny composition, of course, and I'm going just bring little by little everywhere here to make sure that I have distributed everywhere the cement, and create a layer like around half an inch or 1 centimeter, more than 1 centimeter in thickness, all the way around on the face. And that is because I need to have a strong structure underneath built, because on top I will come with a ceramic made out of CDs. Usually I'm using just ceramic, like mosaic, not normal kind, like I'm using just pieces of tiles or plates, leftover plates. But for this one, I'm using something which is unusual, are CDs for mosaic, not ceramic. So I want to make sure that I have enough thickness for the piece to hold the face in a very good way, strong way. So I will continue to build all the way around the face on this piece of cloth. I will let it dry for around 24-48 hours, depending of the humidity in your area. And after that, I will start to build the mosaic, as I said, using the leftover CDs, or the ones that I don't need them, don't want them, and just create like a very nice piece out of it. So this is the way that the project looks now, dried out. And as you can see from the profile, you see the face features. At this stage, I'm not interested to get too much in details with the face, because I'm going to cover the face with those pieces of CDs that I have here. And I'm going to show you at the end, of course, the way that the project looks. So at this stage, as you can see, it's very strong, keeps the shape anyway, it's not moving, it's very, very strong, which is very important for this part of the project, to have a very strong, dry piece. And here in the back, you can see that it's hollow, because I don't want to have too much weight for this piece. And also I want to just finish exactly the way that I'm going to finish the face side. Inside is going to be finished in the same way. Now, you have a few options here. You can keep this piece in this way on a stand, like the way it is, after it's finished, of course. Or you can just use like a bar that I have here and place it in a cement, create a foot for it, and that is going to help you to be raised on a piece of like a foot, that the way you look. Now, for this you need to have a hole that I have it here, as you can see it, and the way that looks here is like so. So you have enough space for the road that you wish to insert it in this piece. So for this part of the project to continue, I'm going to show you how am I using the CDs. I have here CDs that are unwanted. I don't need them, of course. And to get the CDs to split, if you have DVDs, actually not the CDs. CDs are coming in one layer, but DVDs are coming in two-layer part. So for that, you have to just place them in a container, pour hot water over, and let them for probably 3 to 5 minutes. And after that, you can just insert the scissor between the two layers of the DVD, and they will split, and then you can cut them in smaller pieces. It's better to do this in hot water because the CDs are going to get soft, and they will not break when you will try to slice them. So they will slice very easy, very nice in the pieces that you're looking for. So that is a very good tip that you can use it when you are doing this type of project. Now, to put those pieces on my project here, I am using a thin set that has this consistency. It's like a thick yogurt or peanut butter. And also you can use glue, like normal glue, or you can use silicone. All work very well with this kind of project. So basically you are just taking a piece of the CD, place a little bit of the glue or the tin set or whatever is available for you, and just place the piece on top. They are going to dry out, and after that you are going just to come with a little bit of the, if you wish to use the clear glue, you can come between and that will be even better, or you can just keep them very close one to each other, and then the separation is almost seamless, like you can see here. Or you can use any other types of the adhesive that you have available, it doesn't matter. Important is to use your imagination and of course create something out of almost nothing. So I will continue to do this part here and place all those pieces of CDs or DVDs here close one to each other to create that feeling of a creature from your dream, or like an alien kind of creature, which I'm looking now for this project. Now, to have this project, as I said, placed on a stand or on a foot, I will show you how you can do this. So let me just clean up here. Okay. And for this, I have chosen this container that I'm thinking that it's enough for my project. And I'm using this piece of rod that I have available, and also to make sure that the rod stays very firmly in the cement here, I was using some of the utensils that I'm not using them anymore, and I just bend them, put them inside the rod, and I tie them with a little bit of wire. You can use any kind of wire, I'm using this one or any other kind, doesn't matter. Now, to create more stability for the piece here, I'm just using a little bit of the mesh here, that it's a piece of mesh, but you can use wires as well, doesn't matter, you don't have to have this one specifically, but it's better to use as much as you can wires or your leftover pieces of metal to incorporate in this foot to make sure that stays very strong in its place. So I'm just going to place this one here to make sure that stays in the middle. And for the composition here, I have two-part sand, one-part cement, and it's kind of a runny composition. And that is because you need to get this composition underneath of the utensils to make sure that they hold together very well. So you will just mix them a little bit to make sure that you will get them very well. And here you have to just put first a little bit to pour inside to make sure that you have a base underneath the utensils to make sure that are getting in contact with the bin here, with the container. And after that, you pour a little bit more, and to make even better the composition to be stronger, as I said, you can add a little bit more wires or anything you have available, leftover pieces of metal, to make sure that are going to make the contact. I made a hole here, of course, to place the mesh here. And again, it's going to make sure that this piece stays firmly in its place and can hold the weight for the piece that I have created. It's a heavy piece, of course, using so much seam length. Of course, the piece is heavy, so you need a good stand for it to make sure that you won't get in trouble later. So you will have a very nice conversational piece to look for. So here I will continue to add a little bit more cement and just make it sure that stays everything in its place. It's firmly straight. You can just shake it a little bit to make sure that the composition gets everywhere inside the wires that I have used and the utensils. So this is pretty much what you need to do at this stage. You let it dry for 24-48 hours depending of humidity in your area. And after it's dry, you can just remove the container and get the piece out, and you can use it by just paint it, or you can just use any other beads or anything you wish on top to decorate it. I'm getting back to you to show you the final look of my creation. So here is the look of the foot, that it's dry. I removed it from the plastic here container that I used. Now, as you can see, has a nice look everywhere. You can use it in this state, so you can just leave it the way it is, or you can just paint it, or you can just use some pieces of ceramic to create a mosaic on top of it, which I'm trying to do now. And for this, I have here I have chosen this type of ceramic. It's very nice and gives me a very good design here that I can cover, and that works very well for me. So to attach this piece of ceramic to the cement, I'm using here the tin set, which is this has this consistency. It's very thick, and that is the best to work on this type of project. So you have to follow the manufacturer's instructions to get exactly the thickness that you're looking for, and just use it very easy in this way. So basically, I'm going just to place a little bit of the tin set on top of the ceramic and just place it on the piece itself. So that is going to increase the strength for the foot, plus it's going to look absolutely great on the piece itself. So you can continue in this way to cover entire part with the ceramic, and definitely it's going to give you a great look for the piece at the end. So let me show you the way that the piece looks for the final look, and definitely it's going to improve the look of the house as well, or wherever you will place this piece of art. So here is the foot, the way that looks now after I finished to complete with small tiles that I got here. As you can see, it's done all the way around. It's pretty strong, and I finished it underneath too. You don't have to, but I wanted to. So at this point I need to use grout to fill up between the gaps here that I have between the tiles. So for this I'm using this kind of grout. You can use any other kinds, there are few of them on the market, but this doesn't have sand in it, and the consistency for the grout needs to be like this thickness, a little bit runny, and that is because you need this composition to get between the crevices here in the tile, between the tiles. So I'm just going to cover with this grout to fill up every single space here, and I will let it dry for about 3, 4, 5 minutes depending of the humidity in your area, until the grout gets like a haze on top of it, and that means that the composition is ready to be wiped out from the mosaic. So I will just use a wet cloth, and I will just remove the excess of the grout between the pieces of the stones here that I have between the pieces of the mosaic. After it dries out, I will let it 24-hour period to dry completely, and I will just use this kind of sealer, and that it's because when you finish a piece, it's very useful to use this sealer, because helps the piece to stay together and gives a shiny kind of look, and it's going to fill up any other small spaces that you have between the pieces. So it's going to prevent the moisture to try to just get between the pieces here of the mosaic. So when it's finished, I'm going to show you the look of the entire piece, and I'm hoping that you like it and you will be able to do it as well. So here is the head that I finished. So now the entire piece is covered with fragments of the CDs and DVDs. I have covered the inside as well, and that is because wherever you place this piece in the room, you have a good angle and good look from any side of it. So here you can see it shows very clearly the profile, and I can tell you that I'm very happy with the way it looks now, the piece. And for underneath, to make sure that it's not going to scratch the furniture, I have cut a piece of plastic cushion, and this is the way that looks now. So I will show you what I have used. It's very inexpensive. You can buy it just to cover the drawers, and it's very flexible, and as I said, has a thickness that gives it the strength for the piece underneath, and you are not going to scratch any furnitures. Now again, you can use this piece the way it looks now, or you can use with a foot here that I have created, and I used the grout to cover the pieces of the ceramic. And now, because I don't like this white color for the grout, I'm going to cover with this brown color to match as much as I can with the rest of the ceramic pieces. For this I'm using just acrylic paint, and I poured here in this lid, and of course with a brush you can just continue and just cover only the white side of the grout. Let it dry a little bit, like 2-3 minutes, and after that, with a wet cloth, you can come and clean the ceramic immediately. So it's going to look like this way here, where it's already cleaned. So as you can see, it's very neat and it's going to look very nice for the entire ensemble. So I will show you the finished look for the entire project. Again, I'm very happy with the way that looks now, and definitely is going to enhance very well the place where I'm going to put it in my house. Here, another thing that you have to know, because this is a metal bar and I don't want to rub this metal bar against the piece when I will insert through the hole the piece here, I have used a little bit of the same material like here and just put it here to make sure that it's not going to rub the piece. So this is the way that I'm doing this hole here, to have the possibility to insert this bar in the piece and place it on the foot. So again, I will show you the way it looks. So I will hope, I'm hoping that you'll be very happy as well, and you can follow my instructions to create your own project in the same way. So here I have the finished look of the project. As you can see, it's a very nice piece. It's large, very nice to look at, and definitely it's like focal point for the room. And you can see from any angle that looks very nice and reflects very well the light. Again, it was a way to spend my time, and I can tell you that I'm very pleased with the finished look. You can see that from any angle gives you the pleasure to look at. As you can see, it's finished inside as well. So you can place it anywhere in the house, and not only, of course, as I said, and you can have a very nice piece to look at, or a conversational piece of art that you can enjoy over time. You can use it on the foot, on the stand that I have created, and you can use it as well without. So here is the way that the piece looks without the stand or the foot, and as I showed you, it's covered underneath, so it's not going to scratch any furnitures or any place where you'll use it in your home, and has a different look, of course, just a little bit changed, but again, it's going to look very nice, and it's very well made, so no problems that the pieces are coming off or you'll get any damages for the piece itself. So if you have enjoyed with my project and you are interested in more ideas, you can just check my channel, where I have any other videos for the cement or gardening or cinder blocks or painting, modern art or abstract art, or icons, 3D wall design ideas if you are looking for, and many more other ideas. So if you wish to check anything on my channel and you have any questions, you can just let me know, and gladly I will share any information that you're looking for. Thank you again for watching this video. It was a pleasure showing you what I have created. I wish you truly a very good day. Goodbye.